The Mega Dry dehumidifier, specially designed for use in crawl spaces, especially closed crawl spaces. What we have here is a port on both sides, so you have filter replacement capabilities that you can access from either side of the dehumidifier. It also has the ability to hook the condensation line up on either side. Comes with already collared 8-inch duct line attachments, so that if you need to run the air or the return from tighter areas of the crawl space, you are ready to go with that. This dehumidifier is manufactured in the United States. It's ENERGY STAR rated, 70 pints per day. Great dehumidifier for the use in a closed crawl space. The warranty is 1 year on parts and material, 5 years on the compressor. So Mega Dry, the best dehumidifier for your closed crawl space. Now we're going to install the Mega Dry dehumidifier. We've come up with a couple of quick tips. Of course, you can do a number of things, just hold it up. We are going to hang the Mega Dry in this particular situation. We've put nails in and put two temporary hangers at the level that we're going to want the dehumidifier set. This helps stabilize it so that we can get it good and level for the permanent installation. So we're going to work that out and get it done real quick. It's pretty easy with two guys. Do one side. And then the other side. And as you see, we're not perfectly level, but we're close enough to start our strapping. Now that we've got the Mega Dry temporarily hung, we're going to go ahead and install all four of the hangers and get it ready to actually attach to the floor joist. One little quick tip, go ahead and get your screw started in the strap, because that way you don't have to hold it. Note there's two lengths of screws. The short are the screws that you use for the hangers being attached to the Mega Dry unit, and the longer ones are the ones that would go into the wood floor joist. Don't over tighten the straps, just a good snug is all you need. Now, when you're ready to start installing the straps to the joist, you can go ahead, put your level on the unit, and get it close to being right side to side, that's right. The straps have three holes so that you've got opportunity to put a couple of screws in it if you need to. There again, you're just snugging it up. Now that we have the Mega Dry hung and you've got the ability to run positive drain for the condensation line, make sure you use the P-trap that's enclosed. This is very important to keep the unit operating efficiently. And then you just hook up your drain line and you're ready to cut it on. Now that we have the Mega Dry installed, we don't, in this particular situation, have the ability to run the condensation line out with a positive drain, so we're going to use a condensation pump. This is a specially designed unit for this particular Mega Dry. It comes with the pre-drilled holes for mounting to the side. It also comes with the tubing that attaches to the included nipple and the tube that goes down into the condensation pump. Always remember to take and put your condensation pump nipple that has an angle into this part. You don't need the P-trap. Now to finish it off, we put a little loop in our line, attach it, and you want this loop, it's part of that drain stoppage that you need. Now we've got it installed, it's time to cut it on. There's a dial to the left. You want to set it in that ideal setting, which is between 50 and 60%, and let it do its job. And see how quiet it is. Another option for the Mega Dry is to place it on the ground. This unit comes with adjustable legs so that you can level it on place. Good thing to use, some 4-inch solid block, really good to use. Okay. And we're level. This is the Crawlspace Depot Supply Air Inducer. It's designed to put 50 CFM of air into the closed crawlspace. It's built with the butterfly damper that is required by most codes. It also has a constant airflow regulator that will only let 50 CFM pass through this unit. It's pre-gasketed, pre-designed with a collar, so it's easy to install into most trunk line systems. Always remember to put this label up. This damper only operates by gravity, so you want to keep this unit running level outside of the duct and with this label up. So our technician's going to go ahead and show you how we cut the hole and install it. Pick a good place. Some ducts you're going to want to be able to strap it up. Now this is a preformed fiberglass duct, easy to drill through. He's going to peel the protective coating tape off. This gives us our sticky surface to attach and also seals this unit to the duct. He's going to line it up, making sure his label is straight up and down. Then he's going to put a few screws in it. It's not a bad idea to use a little bit of duct strapping to strap the end of that unit up so it doesn't tilt down. An added level of security to make sure that that unit operates efficiently. This unit's self-contained and will last for years and years and years. Another thing we found useful is we flag all of our units in the crawl space so they're easy to find. There's thousands of places to hide these units, and sometimes you need a little help finding it so that you can check that unit annually to make sure everything is operating properly. Here's the importance of wearing your safety protection equipment. Always wear a respirator, gloves, and of course, eye protection. This is a typical application of DSV in a crawl space by a homeowner. Here we have a pre-mixed material already to go in the compressed air sprayer. You want to try to get complete and even coverage of the crawl space area. This disinfects the area of the crawl space from bacteria, fungus, and viruses, and unwanted pathogens that were laying under the vapor barrier in the soil. Now we're going to demonstrate Clean Crawl, a specially formulated, ready-to-use, pleasantly scented stain remover and cleaner to prepare wood and other surfaces and clean them from that mold and mildewy condition. What you're doing here is applying to point of runoff all the wood surfaces and other surfaces within the crawl space area. In areas where you have heavier fungal growth, you may need a brush or a sponge to help remove some of that excess growth. Clean Crawl can be used in crawl spaces, unfinished basements, attics, and other places where you have fungal growth and you need wood or other surfaces cleaned. 1 gallon covers between 75 and 100 square feet. Now we're going to apply PentaShield. It's a penetrating fungicide, termiticide, and preservative that you can apply to wood and concrete surfaces. The good thing about this product, it kills and prevents wood decay, all types of fungi, termites, carpenter ants, and wood-boring beetles. A great product that lasts a long time, too. Now, when you're applying it in the crawl space, you want to hit those outside bands, the seals, the seal plates, also the block wall. It's also a helpful tip just to apply in sections. That way you can kind of keep track with what you're doing. So wet those surfaces to point of runoff on the wooden members, and the block wall, you just want to dampen the block wall. Good application is important. Don't forget, always wear your personal protection equipment such as gloves, eye protection, coveralls in most cases, and of course a little respirator.